Okay, thanks to everybody. Today we'll learn actually another part of measures of dispersion. A practical example. The following this table we have learned about this problem. In our previous lectures, we have found mean, median, mode. Okay, there are three types of mean: arithmetic mean, geometric mean, and harmonic mean. We have evaluated this in our previous lectures, and in our previous lectures we have found mean, median, mode also. Then we have found standard deviation in shortcut method and direct method. We have solved this problem. So using this problem, we want to find the mean deviation and quartile deviation. There are three types of mean deviation. One is mean deviation about mean. Okay, mean deviation about mean or mean deviation from mean. Same words. And mean deviation from median. That means mean deviation about median, denoted by this, and mean deviation about mode, okay, and coefficient of quartile deviation, coefficient of variance also. Then we will find the coefficient of mean deviation, coefficient of mean deviation about mean, coefficient of mean deviation about median, and coefficient of mean deviation about mode. Okay, to find these, we have to use different formulas. Now I am discussing these formulas to use to solve this problem. So first of all, what is actually mean deviation? It would be useless to take the sum of the deviations of the values from the arithmetic mean as a measure of dispersion, since their algebraic sum is zero. So however, if we take the mean of the absolute values of the deviations, we get a useful measure of dispersion, which is called mean deviation from mean, or mean absolute deviation, or simply mean deviation. So if we consider x1, x2, dot, dot, xn observations, there are a number of observations of a variable with mean x bar. Then the deviation is defined by mean deviation about mean 1 by n summation xi minus x bar. But it is for ungrouped data. But you must know, for group data, we have to introduce frequency fi. Okay. So in case of group data, that means, for example, of this mean deviation about mean equals to what formula? 1 by n. This is the formula you have to write down now. 1 by n summation fi xi minus x bar. I have written in whiteboard. This is the formula for what? Mean deviation about mean. If the deviation are taken from the median or mode, then we have to use mean deviation about median, this formula. 1 by n summation fi xi minus.
Sir, it's a group data. Group data, sir?
Yes, this is for group data. In every group data, frequency must, fi must. Okay. Then mean deviation about mode. 1 by n fi summation fi absolute value of xi minus mode. This is the mode. We have found mode, median, and mean from this practical example in our previous lectures. In YouTube, in playlist of statistics for engineer, you must find this. So we will use this table, and I will draw this just using the mean deviation about mean, mean deviation about mode, mean deviation median formula. We get our exact values. Now, suppose another deviation, quartile deviation, quartile deviation. Quartile deviation equals to what? This is the another formula for finding quartile deviation, and which is related to a standard deviation. So quartile deviation equals to what? 2 by 3 standard deviation. And mean deviation from mean can be found from standard deviation, 4 by 5 into standard deviation. This is also formula. You have to write down. You can use this formula for this. Okay, number one formula, quartile deviation equals to what? 2 by 3 standard deviation, and 2 mean deviation from mean, what? 4 by 5 standard deviation. Okay, now what will be the formula for coefficient of quartile deviation? Coefficient of quartile deviation denoted by CQD. Coefficient of quartile deviation is third quartile minus first quartile divided by third quartile plus first quartile multiply 100. Just using this formula, we can find coefficient of quartile deviation. But in our previous lectures, I have found these quartiles from using this example also. So coefficient of variation formula. This is the coefficient of variation formula. Coefficient of variance.
What is coefficient, sir?
Coefficient of variance. This is the formula. Coefficient of variance. Standard deviation divided by x bar multiply 100. Okay. This is the formula for finding this percentage is called coefficient of quartile deviation. Finding quartile deviation, percentage of quartile deviation is called coefficient of quartile deviation. Understand? Coefficient means what? Percentage. Percentage. This is the 100 multiplied 100. This formula is called coefficient of quartile deviation. Coefficient of quartile deviation.
Percentage of quartile deviation is known as the coefficient, sir.
Of course, yes, right. Now, coefficient of variance, what? If we divide standard deviation with mean, then this percentage is called coefficient of variance. Coefficient means always percentage, represented as a percentage. So if we divide standard deviation by mean and take the percentage, we get coefficient of variance. Remember it. We have to use, this is another formula, finding coefficient of variance. So coefficient of deviation formula, what will be? Suppose coefficient of mean deviation about mean, just mean deviation about mean divided by mean multiply 100. This percentage is called coefficient of mean deviation about mean. Coefficient of mean deviation about median, what will be? Mean deviation about median divided by median multiply 100. Okay. And coefficient of mean deviation about mode, what will be? Mean deviation about mode divided by mode multiply 100. Now we'll try to find out this coefficient of by using this formula. Okay. So now we'll try to solve this problem for finding this one. Okay, coefficient of mean deviation of mean, and we have discussed all formula for finding this. Okay. Now we are solving this problem. We have to calculate finding mean deviation about mean, median, and mode. So this is the class interval of this example, practical example, mean values of this, adding divided by 2, and this is the given frequency. Now xi minus x bar, in our previous lectures we have find the mean of this example. Mean is what was actually 279.8. that means xi minus x bar, absolute value of this, how we can find absolute value of this, what will be absolute value? So 254.995 minus 279.8, what will be? 24. Then 264 minus what will be? 279.8, what will be? 14.805. Then next 4.80, also minus, but absolute value will give the positive values. So 284.995 minus 279.8, what will be? 5.195. Then 294 will be what? 294, 15.195. Okay. Then 294, then 304 will be what? 25.195. Next 314 will be what? 135.195. Now just multiplying by frequency. Okay, so multiplying with what frequency? 2 will be what? 70.39. 25.195 multiply, what will be? 5. 125. What will be? 975. Then 15 multiply 10. What will be? 15 multiply 10 will be 151.95. Okay.
Sir, then fi divided xi minus x bar.
Yes. Just this the xi minus x bar multiply fi.
Sir, okay. Multiply by why, sir? Sir, here, sir, fi divided x by, sir, x by.
Fi into, it absolute value. This is absolute value.
Oh, sir, sir.
Absolute value.
This is divided.
Absolute value, 15. Then 5 into 195 multiply what? 14, okay? What will be 72.73. Then what will be the value? 4.805 multiply what will be? 16. Multiply 16, what will be? 76.88. okay, now then 10 multiply 14 point what? 805. What will be? 148.05. just using calculator. Now 24.805 multiply what will be? 8 198. Point what will be? 4 4. Now mean deviation about mean formula, what mean deviation about mean deviation about mean, that means mean deviation about means can be written as like this: summation fi xi minus x bar divided by what will be n. So this summation, what will be this summation? Summation fi xi minus x bar, what will be? Take the sum. Take the sum. 198 plus 148.05 plus 72.73 plus 151.95 plus 125.975 plus 70.39. So we get what actually? 844.415. Summation of frequency what? 65. Okay, n equals to this 65.
So, mean deviation of collision je ki mean jano
844 mean deviation about mean 415 divided by 65, what will be the result? Divided by 65, what will be? 12.991. Okay, approximately. This is the mean deviation about mean. Now similarly, xi minus median. Median what was in our previous lecture? Median what was? Hello. So from earlier classes, we got median equals mean equals to what? Arithmetic mean. X bar equals to 279.8 and median was what? 279.06 and mode was what? 277.5. Now we are finding xi minus median to find out the mean deviation about mode. Median, mean deviation about what? Median, mean deviation about what? Median. What will be the formula? Mean deviation about median, what will be? Summation fi absolute value of xi minus median divided by what will be n. So we have to fill up this xi minus median. Median what was? 27 for this data 279.06. So we get first mid values minus median what? 0.9137. Okay, 9137. Then 264.995 minus 279.06. What will be? Minus. This will be minus. 254. What was? 24 point. Actually, 24 point. This will be 24 point. 24.0 minus 24.065. But absolute before absolute value minus will be cancelled. So 64 will be minus 14.065. So we get 14.065 for absolute value minus will be omitted. Then for 274 minus median, what will be? Minus 4.065. Then 284 point, this will be plus 5.935. 5 point, what will be? 935. Then 94 will be what? 15.935. Okay. 304, what will be? 25.935. Then for 314 minus median, what will be? 35.935. Now multiplying frequency with this, so 2 multiply 35.5, what will be? Multiply 2, 71.87. Now 25.935 multiply what will be? 5. What will be? 129.675. Okay, 675. Now 15.935 multiply what will be? 10. 159 point what will be? 35. Okay, now 5.935 multiply what will be? 14. 83 point what will be? 09. Now 4.065 multiply what will be? Multiply 16. We get 65.04. Then 14.065 multiply 10. What will be? 140.65. Then 24.065 multiply what will be? 8. 192 point what will be? 52. Now take the sum of this. Sum what will be? Summation fi absolute value xi minus median. What will be? Take sum of this. Plus 140.65 plus 65.04 plus 83.09 plus 159.35 plus 129.675 plus 71.87. So we get actually 842.195. So this value what in formula using formula mean deviation about median, what will be mean deviation about median? 842.195 divided by 65. So dividing by 65, we get what? 12.956. That means 12.957. This is the actually mean deviation about median. Mean deviation about median. Now just using this mode from our previous lecture, we got what? 277.5. Just using this mode, subtracting from mid values, each mid values, we get this column. Okay, xi minus mode. Then we get what? Mean deviation about mode. Mean deviation about mode. Mean deviation about mode. So mean deviation about mode formula what? Mean deviation about mode formula. Mean, this is the number 2 formula. Now number 3 formula, mean deviation. Deviation about mode. That means mean deviation about mode like this. Formula will be what? Summation fi xi minus absolute value of xi minus mode divided by n. Just using this formula from this column. Now fill up this column using this mode. We get what? 254.995. 995 minus what will be? 277.5. This mode will be subtracted from each mid values. Then first one minus 22.505, but absolute for absolute value 22.505. Okay, now 264 will be what? Minus 12.505, but for absolute value 12.505. Similarly, 74 will be what? 2.505, minus 2.505. Then 84, what will be? 7.495. Then 94 will be what? 294.995, 17.495. Then 304.995 minus mode, what will be? 27.495. Okay, now 314. What will be 37.495? Okay, now multiplying with the frequency 8, multiply this multiply. So 2 multiply 37.5, what will be? 2 multiply. 2 multiply, what will be? 74.99. Then 27.495 multiply, what will be? 5 137.475. Then 17 multiply 10, 174.95. Then 7.9495 and multiply 14, what will be? 7 14. This will be 104.93. Okay, Now 2.505 multiply what will be 16. We get 40.08. Now 12.505 multiply 10. 125.05. Okay. Then 180 point what will be 04. So we get, now take the sum, we get summation of what? Summation of summation Fi Xi minus mod এটা কত পাচ্ছি আমরা রেজাল্টটা টু প্লাস করে দেখি 180.04 প্লাস 125.05 প্লাস 40.08 প্লাস 104.93 প্লাস 174.95 প্লাস 137.475 then 74.99. So this equals to, we get 837. This sum, this column sum 837.515. There is a mistake, but you can check. So mean deviation about mode from this column, we can write summation of this, what will be 837.515 divided by what will be 65. So divided by 65, what will be 12.885 approximately. So this, in previous we got mean deviation about mean using this one, we get this and takes making this sum, this divided by 65, we got mean deviation about mean. Similarly, Fi multiply absolute value of Xi minus median, using this formula we got mean deviation about median from this column and mean deviation about mode from the last column. Okay, just using mode from our previous lecture, we have calculated this. So from any group data, we can find out the mean deviation about mean, mean deviation about median, and mean deviation about mode using this table and using the formula I have shown you in the earlier of this classes. Now coefficient of mean deviation, coefficient of mean deviation, there are three types of coefficient of mean deviation. One is coefficient of mean deviation about mean. Coefficient of mean deviation about mean, what was from our result? Tell me. This is the formula, mean deviation about mean divided by
mean
multiply 100.
100.
So mean deviation about mean, what was? This is the mean deviation about median.
12.991
divided by mean, what was mean?
279.8.
Find the result using calculator. Coefficient of mean deviation about median, what will be? Mean deviation about median divided by median multiply 100. This equals to what? Mean deviation of median 12.957 divided by median, what? 279.06 multiply 100. This is multiply 100. What?
4.6443.
Then this one. Coefficient of mean deviation about mode. What will be? Mean deviation about mode divided by mode multiply 100. This was what? 12.885 divided by mode 277.5 multiply 100. This result what? Coefficient of mean deviation about median what?
4.643.
Next result, find out. Then next, coefficient of variance.
4.646
approximately. Remember it. Approximately all are result. So approximately. Now coefficient of variance formula what? Standard deviation divided by mean multiply what? 100. In our previous lectures, we found just this previous lecture. You can see the video. What was the standard deviation? What was the standard deviation in our previous lecture? For this example, what was the standard deviation? Do you know what was the standard deviation?
Sir, 284.
Standard deviation as well what?
Sir,
254.995. No, sir, 284. 254, maybe, standard deviation. In direct method, we got 254.25, but in shortcut method, as well what, 15.6. So this will be 254.
Which one we will use, sir? Direct or formula, sir?
In direct method, we got what, 254.25 divided by mean what? 279.8 multiply 100. Find the result by using calculator. Now another one, coefficient of quartile deviation. Coefficient of what? Quartile deviation. Coefficient of quartile deviation. What will be the formula? Third quartile minus first quartile divided by what? Third quartile plus first quartile multiply 100. So in our previous lectures, what was the first quartile? Third quartile you must know. Can you tell me the values?
Sir,
third quartile what?
So 219.75.
First quartile what?
So 290, sir. Sorry, it is 290.
Okay. Sir. Then this will be first quartile what?
268.25
divided by 290.75 plus 268.25. We got this from our previous lecture. Using this example, we found first quartile, third quartile, second quartile, everything. Multiply 100. You can get the approximate result for this. Just how to find the coefficient of different deviation, coefficient of mean deviation about mean, this coefficient of mean deviation about median, coefficient of mean deviation about mode, then coefficient of variance, that means covariance. It is also called standard deviation divided by mean multiply 100. All coefficient will represent the percentage. Remember it. Okay. So Okay, thanks to everybody. If you do practice, you can solve these types of problem. Okay, best wishes for you.